We play for real. And 15 years between NHL games here. What a pleasure it is to be back in Winnipeg. The starting goaltenders, there's veteran Brian Boucher, who has left the goaltending vortex of Philadelphia for the relative calm of backing up Cam Ward in Carolina this year. At the other end, it will be Chris Mason, the Red Deer native, getting his first full game of the preseason, slated to be Andre Pavlik's backup here in Winnipeg this year. And between the benches at the MTS Center, Ray Ferraro. Ray, it doesn't feel like a preseason game.
Absolutely not, man. Does the sound ever rattle around this building? We heard it just in the anthem, and here we go with puck drop. One player to watch tonight for Winnipeg is Brian Little. 31 goals 3 years ago, Chris. Just 31 the last 2 years combined. The Jets need more from Brian Little.
And isn't it neat to watch from the start the seventh round pick, or the number seven pick overall from this year's draft? Mark Scheifele on the ice against the number seven man from two drafts ago, the Calder Trophy winner, Jeff Skinner. Here's a steal and a quick chance here in front for Scheifele. Not able to get the shot away. He's on a line with Evander Kane and Jason Gregoire. Puck played down into the Winnipeg zone, and Scheifele back to help out defensively. And now Bogosian, as the Jets are in the midst of a change. Festerling plays it ahead, the former Vancouver Giant. There's Alexander Burmistrov. He's out playing with Yanni Pasanen. Pasanen getting a more of a look here. He has had a Charlie horse and has missed a couple of days of practice and hasn't really seen some game action yet. So Pasanen, Antropov on the ice flanking Burmistrov. There's Boucher playing it. Brian Allen chops at it. And Carolina trying to get control, flips it out to center ice. And Ron Hainsey trying to play it back in, sends it into the Carolina bench.
Didn't take very long for Mark Scheifele to show a little bit of zip to his game. Claude Noel talks about his hockey IQ. He jumps the loose puck in the Carolina zone, and he's that close to getting through Jay Harrison. He probably should shoot the puck from that position, because he's close enough to use Harrison as a screen, but he was quick on the loose puck and chipped it by Caberle. That close to its scoring chance.
He was the first star in the game here at the MTS Center. They felt his game dropped a little bit in Nashville, but was back to the same form we saw in the opener in the game in St. John's, Newfoundland. Here's the chance in front of the backhand is slipped wide by the captain, Andrew Ladd. This is the top line for Winnipeg. Brian Little at the side of the net, centered! And Derek Meach off the point came in, had his stick lifted. The Winnipeg native vying for a spot on the blue line for the Jets, the team he grew up cheering for. In fact, Derek Meach was at Winnipeg Arena for the final ever game of the first edition of the Winnipeg Jets. Here comes Little again, his centering pass. Ladd with a chance, he's knocked down, and Boucher will cover up. Quick start for that top Winnipeg line.
Well, that's the type of play they need from Brian Little. What a terrific first shot, first shift for Brian Little, and it starts with a steal. He comes up from behind. Joslin doesn't know he's there. He steals the puck, and he's got Ladd in the slot. Ladd tries to shovel a pass across to Wheeler, and then as the play continues, here's that feed across Little to Meach. Nice back check by Grayson Bowman, but a good read by Meach, who is in that fight for that last defense job off the Little pass.
A couple of fourth line players come out onto the ice now. As here's Samson, who finished the year with Carolina. Shot off the side of the net. We've got a delayed penalty coming up, and Winnipeg will be shorthanded first on the night. And it is Zach Bogosian heading to the penalty box.
This is maybe a scrutinized player this side of Dustin Byfuglien here in Winnipeg, and Bogosian gets called for holding here. He gets his right arm wrapped around Samson. Bogosian kind of lost his way defensively the last couple of years in Atlanta. A high draft pick who has got all kinds of potential, great size, minus 45 the last two seasons after a plus 11 rookie season.
Faceoff won, but the Jets unable to clear. Thomas Caberle First time in his NHL career of 13 years that he starts a season somewhere other than Toronto. And Paul Maurice, a former Leaf coach, has put him on the right point to start this power play. Canes have not worked on their power play and are 0 for 8 in the preseason. Here's Jussi Jokinen down low. Skinner a chance, and Mason down to make the save. And Skinner with a little shove behind the net that gets some attention.
Although they haven't worked on the power play, this is a fairly standard set. And Caberle will take the puck to the middle of the ice, clear some room for Jokinen to Skinner. Skinner fans on the shot, but you see the room that is created once Jokinen gets the puck up high. Festerling is up a little bit too high, and that gives room for Jeff Skinner to attack the net.
Ryan Little against Skinner on the faceoff, a clean win for Little. Faceoffs have been a problem for Carolina over the last couple of years. Here comes Andrew Ladd, Ryan Little, and he couldn't take the pass cleanly on a two-on-one shorthanded opportunity.
The pass from Ladd bobbled right when it got to Little's stick, or else he's in position for a 15-foot chance on Brian Boucher.
Ladd sent it back, and you saw Brian Little just touch the puck inside the line, putting the play offside.
Brian Little's had a nice start to this game for the Jets. He wins the draw, and when Jones clears the puck past Caberle at the point, it opens up the two-on-one. Ladd wants to pass it. You see the puck take a half hit, half skip when it gets to Brian Little's stick.
Minute 11 left in the Bogosian penalty, and now Mark Scheifele, the youngster, will take a turn on the penalty kill along with Evander Kane. Mark Stewart's on defense along with the veteran Randy Jones, the New Brunswick native, and former Tampa Bay Lightning defenseman, at least played last year in Tampa Bay. He's also seen action in Philadelphia and Los Angeles. There's a youngster, Justin Falk, out of the University of Minnesota Duluth, who is highly touted. We will not see Ryan Murphy tonight, a kid from the Kitchener Rangers who has really made an impression in camp.
Chris, I watched both Falk and Murphy at the Prospects Tournament in Traverse City, and when they handle the puck, the two of them, they're so confident. The Carolina Hurricanes are thrilled with the potential for the future with these two kids.
Here's Scheifele, and he pounds it off the boards and down the ice, and that should just about do it. Last call is Bogosian, less than 10 seconds remaining in his penalty. Dangerous play there as McBain brought it out in front of the net, lost the puck, and now the Jets have it. Back onto the ice comes Bogosian. Two shots for Carolina on the power play. Here's Derek Meeks, tees, and that shot off a Hurricane and out of play.
Paul Maurice, the Hurricanes coach, was saying prior to coming into training camp, when he thought about his team, he figured forward was going to be where all the competition was going to be at, as guys aligned their fighting for their jobs. But perhaps with the play of Falk and Murphy, the real competition is going to turn out on the back end. They should be a far more mobile defense as they try to make up those 2 points that separated them from a playoff spot in the New York Rangers last year.
Of course, they were eliminated on the final game of the regular season, a devastating 6-2 loss against the Lightning. A win would have vaulted them into the postseason. Troy Bodie's had a good camp for Winnipeg. The Portage-LaPrairie native taken off the puck by Jay Harrison, but the Jets get it back. That's Patrice Cormier along with Bodie. Cormier chips it behind the net, and now a delayed penalty upcoming against Carolina. Extra attacker comes on. It's Ladd who feeds Bogosian across for Mark Stewart. The former Bruin with a shot, and that whistles off the glove. Ladd's got it. Plays it behind the net. Here's Maxwell. Holds. Look to center. Now feeds the point. Across to Stewart. Back for Bogosian. Bogosian, great pass. Andrew Ladd holds him. A big stop by Boucher. Ladd had a little room short side, and Boucher made the stop. And now he'll hold on. Good pressure by the Jets. And we'll see the Jets go to their first power play of the night.
I played in Atlanta, and I can't underestimate how much more exciting it's going to be for these players to play here with a full building. It's amazing to me how exciting this place seems to be already. The fans want to cheer. They want something to look good at. And Bogosian's pass to Ladd was something they'll be happy with. Bogosian, good vision, Ladd with another chance on goal. Brian Boucher with a couple of good saves, and here come the Jets on their first power play.
So Brett Sutter in the penalty box.
Carolina penalties number 42, Brett Sutter.
Bogosian and Meech will play the point. Scheifele will start with Kane and Gregoire. So Claude Noel using a regular line, not stacking things up here. A lead feed for Gregoire. The North Dakota product checked by Fulk. Kane gets it back. Derek Meech has moved up. The former Detroit Red Wing. Now Scheifele up high. Plays it back towards Kane. Knocked off his stick. And Patrick Dwyer clears to center. Bogosian gets control. He's got Meech going down the right flank. Meech overskates it, and Carolina sends it down the ice.
When you look at this Winnipeg power play, their two mainstays on the blue line, Toby Enstrom and Dustin Byfuglien, of course, are not in the lineup. They really make that power play run.
Both over 50 points last year. Fourth and fifth among NHL defensemen in scoring. Here's Brandon Sutter back the other way. Bogosian slowed him up. And now played to the captain, Andrew Ladd. Andrew Ladd, of course, a Carolina draft choice, won a cup in 2006. Mentioned this morning all the great experience on that team. People like Grindemore, Wesley, Mark Recchi, Doug Waite. The list went on. Bogosian fires. That's off the skate to Jay Harrison. Picked up here by Blake Wheeler, right in front of the net. And now Bogosian fires. And Boucher makes the stop off the logo. Kept in by Bogosian, and now Dwyer's got it. And away he goes. Big hit there as Dwyer now peels off and goes to the bench as Wheeler wheels through center, full tilt. Slowed up by Jokinen. Now boom, but Wheeler tries to jam. Little a poke at it. And it's stopped by Boucher. Another close call, Brian Little. And Blake Wheeler come close. Now Zach Dolpe, who's had a good camp for Carolina with a quick shot. And Mason stops that. And Carolina kills their first penalty of the game. A couple of shots for Winnipeg with the man advantage. Pretty good pace to start, Ray.
Very good pace for the Jets. They're a step quicker than Carolina all over the ice here.
Vermeestrop, Antropov, and he wired that well wide. All the way out to center. And now Hainsey steps up and plays it back into Carolina ice. There's Vermeestrop on it. Top 10 pick 2 years ago, 6 goals in his rookie season. Now chipped by Grayson Bowman out to center. Brent Festerling, the former Vancouver Giant. And now Hainsey, the veteran, slowing things down. Feeding it ahead off the skate to Antropov, who heads to the bench. Ryan Allen. And now Thomas Kamerle. Caberle slips the pass through, and Brandon Sutter to the attack. Quick shot, handled by Mason. Sutter saying this morning he wants to be a better offensive player this year. Certainly has the defensive end of the game down. Here comes a shot from Bogosian. Rebound! Off the post! Loose in front, and knocked away! Ben Maxwell missed the gaping net. Not sure how that stayed out, Ray.
The puck was deflected, and Boucher wasn't able to get a handle on it. And the loose puck is sitting right in the crease. Whiffed by Maxwell, a foot and a half from the goal line.
Now Brett Sutter on the ice. We've seen Brandon. And Brody Sutter was in Carolina camp. Just sent back to Lethbridge. But can you imagine? Maybe 2 or 3 years from now, we'll be watching 3 Sutters on the same team.
Brody Sutter was at that prospects tournament as well. He looks identical on the ice to Brandon Sutter. Same right-handed shot, same build, same skating style.
Brody, the son of Dwayne. Puck chipped in by Riley Nash, a first-round pick of the Edmonton Oilers, who's been acquired by Carolina. And this, we're told, a much better camp for Riley Nash here than last year with the Hurricanes. Here comes Skinner with a good jump. Jeff Skinner over the line, and a hot shot handled by Mason. And a pretty good looking rush by the Calder Trophy winner.
Ben Maxwell had a wide open net to break the scoreless tie, and he was foiled by Brandon Sutter. Here comes the shot from the wing. It deflects before it gets to Brian Boucher. Maxwell whiffs on the puck right here as Sutter shoves him from behind just enough to pull his stick off the ice. And that slap shot from the wing, when it was deflected by Brian Allen, it fooled Brian Boucher. And Ben Maxwell will be seeing that one a little later on.
Evander Kane can't clear the zone. Picked off by Skinner and knocked away by Randy Jones. There's Jussi Jokinen. 30-goal scorer a couple of years ago for Carolina. On the wing with Jeff Skinner tonight. As Carolina looks at Skinner at center, also a candidate for a wing position on the line with the big guy, Eric Staal, who isn't in the lineup tonight.
Well, they're going to have to replace Eric Cole, who signed in Montreal as a free agent, who is the regular winger for Eric Staal.
Alexei Ponikarovsky and Anthony Stewart signed as free agents to pick up that slack. Gregoire sends it across. Ron Hainsey on the backhand, and there's Kaberle, and he is taken to the boards heavily by Evander Kane. Gregoire up with the puck, tries to center it, and Kaberle had Kane tied up. And it's bounced back down into Winnipeg ice. Shots even at six apiece, and an icing call against the Canes.
Evander Kane's in his third year. The rookie from the former Vancouver Giant came into the league, made it as an 18-year-old, and had a terrific rookie season. Loves to score. 14 goals in his rookie season, 19 goals last year. Everybody loves to score. Some guys love it just a little bit more. Kane is one of those players.
The only players from the 2009 draft with more goals and points than Kane. Here's a chance in front! And it ricochets to the corner where Wheeler battles for it. The only two are John Tavares and Matt Duchene, who are the two picked ahead of him. There's a stop by Boucher.
Well, Brian Boucher's had a really good start here for Carolina. He was signed so they could get Cam Ward out of the net once in a while in Carolina. And he's a veteran guy, of course, but he's had a very nice start. They feel they can use him more than they were able to use Justin Peters last year.
Cam Ward, a league-leading 74 games. Boucher with the smile said it's a little quieter in Carolina than in Philadelphia.
Oh, I would think so.
There's a chance for Little, and Boucher got a piece of that, and then pocket picked, and Skinner there to clean up the mess and clear the puck. Boy, Brian Little has been noticeable as he looks skyward going to the bench after a missed chance. Brian Allen, an outlet pass, and Carolina gives it up in their own zone. Antropov's there on the forecheck for Mistrop, gets it back to him. Here's Bogosian. Defers. Mark Stewart will shoot. Antropov battling for the rebound and couldn't control it to get a good shot away against Brian Allen. Now Burmistrop's up with it. He's looked quick in this first period. Antropov tries to stop, and Boucher, paddle down, will hold on. Back at the MTS Center in Winnipeg, where moments ago Ray spoke with the captain, Andrew Ladd.
Andrew, much has been made of the move up here to Winnipeg and the difference playing in this building as opposed to a much quieter place in Atlanta. I was there, I know what it was like. Explain what it's like out here.
You just got that extra jump. Every time you come onto the ice, it's exhilarating when you call for a warm-up and there's packed house, and you just got to go from there.
How do the Jets be a more consistent team than the Thrashers were last year when they had the great start and faded late?
It's a mental thing, I think. I think we kind of let off the gas there last half of the year. We're a skating team. We got to get up ice and pressure. And when we don't do that, then we're in trouble.
All the best, Andrew. Thanks.
All right, thanks, Ray.
Even Paul Maurice this morning was saying that he thinks it'll be worth a considerable advantage for Winnipeg to be playing before this home crowd, where there wasn't often a lot of energy in that building in Atlanta.
Ron Haynes, he said to me in warm-up, he said, wow, a little different. He said, people in the stands, you guys are here. And we never saw any of this in Atlanta.
Puck swatted back in by Dwyer. The last five shots in this period have gone to Winnipeg. 11-6, the advantage for the Jets in a scoreless opening period. As Randy Jones looks up ice. Jones headmans the puck, Shifley to the left side. There's 15. Bad angle shot handled easily by Boucher. Scheifele gets it back. Tries to center it. That deflects over the glass into the seats.
When Mark Scheifele is talked about, they talk about his hockey IQ. Now, the breakout passes from Randy Jones, and Scheifele comes off the bench into the middle of the ice. But when he gets to the middle, his feet are moving so Jones can hit him in stride. That pushes Carolina's defense back and allows Scheifele room to find Evander Kane on the left side.
Randy Jones battled to keep it in at the point. There's Scheifele backing him up. And no, defensive coach Charlie Huddy, who's seen some pretty good offensive players, talked about Scheifele just always being in the right place at the right time offensively. That's a knack, isn't it? Here comes the Hurricanes, and Grayson Bowman drips that shot high and off target. Bowman comes up with it again. His shot is stopped and held by Chris Mason, still scoreless in Winnipeg. Well, is it lucky pick number 7? It was for Carolina last year. They got the Calder Trophy winner, and Mark Scheifele is making an instant impression here in Winnipeg. And those two skated together, Ray, a couple of times this offseason in Kitchener, where Scheifele's from, and Skinner played his junior hockey. When we asked Scheifele this morning about Jeff Skinner, he said, yeah, I'd like to be able to match what he did. I'd like to be able to better it. So he's not shy about making an impact in his first rookie, in his first year in the league.
Jeff Skinner had one tremendous season last year. It was really impressive to watch him play. Such a good skater, but so smart.
Here's Wheeler, 2-on-1, along with Ladd, and the pass hopped over the skate. A stick of Andrew Ladd, and Wheeler looked like he was in a pretty good place to shoot.
He was in a really good place to shoot. Claude Noel is going to mention to his players, without question, you get that close, shoot it. That's twice Thomas Caberle's been beaten on a pinch already here in the first period. And I know older players kind of ease their way into games, but Caberle's got to be a little bit more sure about the pinch. When Jokinen loses the puck here, he's got to retreat. There's no business staying in at the blue line there. Wheeler can shoot this now. And instead he tries to shovel it to Ladd. Even if that pass gets there, it's so deep to the net. There's a really difficult angle for Andrew Ladd to try and deflect the puck. Wheeler's way better off shooting that puck there. It's good to be unselfish, but once in a while, you have to put your selfish hat on and get the puck on the net.
What we are seeing, though, is that top line generating a lot of scoring chances in this first period. They haven't finished yet, but Ladd, Little, and Wheeler have looked good so far tonight. Boucher out to stop it behind the goal. Justin Falk takes a bump along the boards. Troy Cody looks for it. And now it's Maxwell on the forecheck. Here comes Falk. And that's off a stick of Nash and out of play. Well, NHL on TSN preseason action continues tomorrow. Check that. The Winnipeg Jets have a new home on Canada's sports leader. Catch over 50 regional Jet games on our special TSN Jets channel. For more information and channel listings, visit tsn.ca/jets. Dennis Bayak and Brian Engblom on the broadcast crew here for the regional games. Here's Antropov over the line. His pass intended for Bermistroff was intercepted. And Randy Jones back in his own zone. Veteran defenseman looks rink wide. There's Pasanen. Yanni Pasanen back across, and that'll be flipped by Talusti into the Winnipeg zone. Pasanen will fire it in. Boucher knocks it down behind the Carolina net. McBain tried to feed it ahead. That was disrupted, and now it rolls out to center. Sent back in by Hainsey. Both teams change. 3.5 minutes remaining in the opening period. Here's Caberle with a move over the line and then had it knocked off his stick. Almost got caught again. G. Harrison backs him up. Those two played a little bit together in 2006 when Harrison was called up to the Leafs under Paul Maurice. And the coach says Harrison has had a very strong camp. Here's a chance for Bowman and a quick shot into the club of Chris Mason.
We've talked almost exclusively about the players fighting for a job with the Winnipeg Jets. Drayson Bowman is one of the forwards with Carolina that's in a spot of competition as well. He's had a couple of chances here early in this period. He can really shoot the puck, a former 50-goal scorer with Spokane in the Western Hockey League. Bowman, who is from Colorado, has had success at the American Hockey League level, and he and Samson are in direct competition for either that 13th forward spot or maybe the first call-up spot. Both of them have scored in the American League. Now they got to translate it to the NHL.
Penalty upcoming against Carolina. And it's going to be the veteran Brian Allen going off for a trip, and we'll get another look at the Winnipeg Jet power play.
Puck goes past Allen at the blue line, and Wheeler kind of stumbles. The call is made, and Allen will go to the box. And Winnipeg, which had some very dangerous chances on their first power play, will get their second one here.
5 for 20 in the preseason for the Jets with a man advantage. Andrew Ladd to Derek Meach. Back to the captain. Meach across, and now Bogosian sets up along the half-court side of the net. Wheeler centered. And Andrew Ladd couldn't take that hot pass. Wheeler gets it back. And now Tim Brent acquired in large part to help improve the Carolina penalty killing. Gets it down the ice.
Had a really good season for Toronto last year. Had the 8 goals, but it was his penalty killing and face-off prowess that the Canes wanted and needed from their fourth-line center.
Ray, we did a game last year when Tim Brent almost single-handedly killed off a 5-on-3 Carolina advantage against Toronto, and you wonder if that one was filed away by Jim Rutherford and company.
Well, they needed an upgrade on that position. They felt they wanted to be a little stronger, and Brent, who was a talented player in juniors, kind of had to morph his career into a little bit more of a checking role, and that shift would go a long way to making him notice.
Wheeler across, Meach has moved up. As they keep it on the outside, they're shot off the side of the net. Meach does have a goal in the preseason for Winnipeg. Spins it back for Andrew Ladd. Ladd tees, fires, but the shot is blocked, and Yuri Talusti will send it down.
As they moved around on that power play, Zach Bogosian ended up in front of Brian Boucher. Blake Wheeler ended up on the point.
You spend a lot of time working on the power play at this point in the preseason?
Well, you will once you get down to one group. I mean, it's so hard to work on it when the team has two or three groups to go through, but there's generally not much work done early in the preseason. That comes for that 9-day break that they have between the end of the last exhibition game and the start of the season.
As an example is how fragmented it's been. This is the first game of the preseason where the Jet coaching staff has all been together behind the bench. In the final minute of this first period, and Bermistroff, and that shot was well wide of the net, and then the stick broke, and he'll have to go to the bench. After a frenzied start, pace is settled. Here's Festerling out. Right wing pass cut off, and it comes right back to Festerling. This time he'll get it in deep. McBain coming off shoulder surgery after a good rookie year. Out there for Carolina, and he hops up and takes the pass. And showing a lot of promise as an offensive defenseman for Carolina, and they've got a bunch of them with Falk and Ryan Murphy. Here's Skinner to the side of the net. Skinner tries the wrap, and Mason covered the short side. McBain at the point, can't get the shot through. It is blocked and cleared, and that will do it for the opening 20 here in Winnipeg. The shots 12-10 in favor of the Jets. Good first period for Boucher and Mason as we check back in with James Duthie. Today about the fact that this team, of course, inherited, they have not built this as their organizational model. He said, we've got good pieces, but they're adjusting to somebody else's original model, that being put together in Atlanta. But there's one of the best pieces right there, the captain.
Yeah, Chris, it could be a lot worse, though. You could be starting on the ground floor, have no assets, and try to build an organizational plan that's 15 years away. They have some very solid assets here in Winnipeg that they inherited from Atlanta. Now that their job is to put those assets in the right order. They have a good one here, it looks like, in Scheifele. They have some solid first-round picks. They've added a player like Dustin Byfuglien. The building blocks are here to try and create something, and they don't even have to start on the ground floor.
Well, including the man that just took the opening faceoff of the second period. These Jets have 7 top 10 picks in their lineup for this game. 10 first-rounders. That's in tonight's lineup. Preseason action. Here's Cavalier at the point. His shot is off target. UC Jokinen to the side of the net. Zap. Dalpy looks for it. Paris, Ontario product. Dalpy, who looks like he's got a strong chance of cracking this lineup. In fact, Beaumaurice said this could be a line for Carolina during the year. Skinner, Jokinen, and Dalpy.
Dalpy had 57 points last year in the American League. He played some in the NHL. He's ready to make the jump, they feel. And to make the jump not as a depth player, but as a top six forward.
Here's Talusti sending it away, and a breakaway opportunity scores. Tim Brent sent home free, and the Hurricanes break the ice early in the second period.
Mark Stewart was standing right in front of me. He got caught halfway on a change. The puck got turned over at the Carolina blue line. And the quick up to Tim Brent, he makes no mistake beating Chris Mason on the breakaway. Caberle to Talusti is the quick up. Now Stewart is changing, and so there's nobody on the ice on that side. And Brent absolutely freezes Mason to the ice here and finishes it to give Carolina the lead.
Now wait a minute. It's Carolina, isn't it?
It is Carolina.
Brent from Talusti and Caberle has a Toronto ring to it, doesn't it?
It certainly does. There is quite a strong Toronto flavor. Lineup.
It is Toronto South with Paul Maurice behind the bench. Again, Alexei Konikarovsky not in the lineup, but ticketed for perhaps a spot on the wing with Eric Staal. So a first minute goal here in the second period, Brent from Talusti and Caberle. And just to add to that lead note, they feel that Bodogorovsky's best season was when he played with Matt Sundin. And they think that Staal and Sundin are very similar players, and one of the reasons why Bodogorovsky was signed.
Well, he really, really hit the ditch last year in Los Angeles. And in that first round playoff series against San Jose, to me, he looked like he was willing. He just couldn't get there. So that'll be a challenge for him.
Ron Hainsey unable to keep it in. And now a stretch pass has Drayson Bowman away. Here's Bowman moving in, and that's off Hainsey's stick and out of play.
When you make a change, that puck has to go past the defenseman. Now, Stewart thinks he's fine because the puck's deep, but Caberle makes a real simple pass to Talusti, and Talusti has his head up. He sees that there's nobody on that side of the ice. You see Randy Jones skating back into the play, number 12 for Winnipeg. He doesn't even have his stick held the right way. He's just jumped on the ice. There's no way he can get back in the play, and Brent has clear sailing.
Jets without the same jump that they had in the opening period to start. Now the big line comes out. Ladd, Little, and Wheeler trying to get the momentum back. Sansone down the right wing for Carolina. He'll chip it in, and there's Brett Sutter on it. Off the side of the net, Sansone looks for it. He's being watched by Ladd, and goes after it in the corner. Brett Sutter along the wall. Loose and Festerling plays it to the near side. Carolina winning more races to the puck here. In period number 2.
They won more races in the first 3 minutes, CC, than they did in that first period, and the difference is predictable. All of a sudden, they have the puck more often.
Now Ladd gets it back. Over the line, lost it in his skates. And in a change, if Skinner goes back to the attack. Here's Skinner trying to drag it through. What a move! And then rolled it wide as he turned Derek Meach inside out.
Oh my, what a fantastic move by Skinner. Squeezing through, putting the puck through his own feet to get around Derek Meach.
I was amazed to read that he worked hard on his skating in the offseason, trying to improve that. And that looked like one of his signature strengths, his great skating ability, but he wants to be even stronger on his skates against bigger men in the National Hockey League.
See, he looked in the period, that first period, a little bit that we've seen him here. He looks a little bit quicker to me. He was so agile last year. It's certainly not going to lose that, but he looks a little bit quicker to me.
Now pass ahead. Troy Bodie just got out of the way of a Brian Allen hit. Gets it in deep. Winnipeg changes. Justin Falk up on the tape. Here's DeLusty. Trying to spring another breakaway pass. And that one was broken up. Stewart lost it. Here's DeLusty, and he wires that wide of the net. And Carolina generating the chances here in the opening 5 minutes of the second period. DeLusty trying to barge through, and we've got a Winnipeg penalty, and now Brandon Sutter exchanging shoves. Stuart Bogosian there for the Jets.
Now this is, of course, not as random a matchup as Carolina at Winnipeg. These teams have been in the same division playing each other six times a year since the Thrashers came into the league. Now it seems a little bit more random that there would be some bad blood between the two teams. This started in the corner where Sutter had started the battle for the puck and got tied up with Mark Stewart. Stewart, who was victimized on a bad change on that first goal, takes a roughing penalty, and now Carolina, who didn't get much done on their first power play, will get their second.
Hurricanes struggled on the power play last year, ranked 24th in the league. Penalty killing was a huge problem for Atlanta last year, and one that Claude Newellen, the Jets, hope doesn't follow them to Winnipeg. They were ranked 27th in killing penalties and have given up six power play goals so far in the preseason. Skinner hands it off, and here's McBain. Sends it across. That shot by Caberle doesn't get through. McBain and Caberle. Dalby, Jokinen, and Skinner. The centering pass is sent out and down the ice by the Jets.
CC, in the first period, you talked about Jamie McBain having a nice offensive season. It's not a hard picture to paint for Carolina that their right side of defense would be Ryan Murphy, Justin Falk, and Jamie McBain, three exceptional young puck movers.
Boy, it's nice to have that in the treasure chest for down the road.
30 points last year for McBain. The step for him would be to be a little more predictable in his defensive zone, less erratic.
Puck cleared by Bogosian. And here is Folt, a power play specialist in college hockey. Grayson Bowman is in, and Mason down to make that stop. Back at the point, Joslin dishes it off. Bowman's shot doesn't get through. He'll get it again. Bogosian sends it around, and it deflects up onto the netting. And that stops play with 44 seconds left in the Mark Stewart minor.
Grayson Bowman had a couple of shots in the first period. He takes a nice feed from Justin Falk. Watch at the Atlanta blue line. Bogosian is preoccupied with the skater going across the middle of the ice, and he gets beat to the outside. That's a nice look by Justin Falk, who gives it to Bowman in stride. Bowman doesn't get anything on the shot, but Bogosian has to be a little more aware of that outside lane. The guy going across the middle of the ice is of no concern. That's for his partner. He makes a misread, and Bowman has a scoring chance.
Jeff Skinner's on the ice now to finish this power play. A half minute left. Skinner, in his rookie year, an offside at the line, had only six power play goals of his 31 in his rookie season. You'd expect that to be higher in year number two.
Chris, you talked about him improving his skating. This is where I think he's a little quicker. One little step and threw his own feet around Derek Meach. I mean, there's not many players that can make that type of move. Skinner does it with such confidence that it's hard to believe he's just in his second training camp.
Another nice move off the boards there as he got past Maxwell, and then Maxwell in turn intercepts a pass and dumps it back down. It's last call for this second Hurricane power play. As Stewart's back in 5 seconds. Skinner to the attack. He can't cross the line. And that will do it. Stewart's back on the ice. But the Jets have played close to 6.5 minutes of the second period without a shot on goal. A get things turned around, and they've got Evander Kane out with Burmistrov and Wheeler. So as Claude Noel starting to change up the lines, we will see. Derek Meeks looks rink wide. It gets by Kane. And now a lead pass out at center. Here's Samson over the line. Brett Sutter trying to return it. Meech broke it up. Derek Meech, who went to the Nick Lidstrom School of Defense in Detroit for the last few years.
It's a good school.
Yep. And also was a partner with Chris Chelios at times. So that's about as well as you can be steeped on the blue line, isn't it?
They've just got to find another 40-year-old defense partner.
Right now, Meech out on the ice as Evander Kane turns. Wheeler charging, looking for that pass, but it was broken up by Jay Harrison. Now Burmistrov over the line. Alexander Burmistrov into the middle, and he lost control of it, but will draw a penalty. An elbowing call upcoming.
Jay Harrison sits in the penalty box for Carolina. He might have been a couple of inches from a visit to Brendan Shanahan as he misses Alexander Burmistrov. As Burmistrov's got his head down. Now, if Harrison leads with his shoulder, there's nothing wrong with it, but he leads with his elbow. You see, Burmistrov is helping the official know that it was an elbowing penalty. They already got it. And the Jets go on the power play looking for the equalizer.
Little lad Wheeler, Meech with the shot, and Bogosian on the points as the Jets look for the equalizer, and Carolina turns them back as it's sent down the ice by Tim Brent, out with Patrick Dwyer in a penalty-killing role for Carolina. Pass too far for Wheeler, and the Hurricanes send it back on Chris Mason. Still no shots for Winnipeg in the second period as we pass the 8-minute mark. A strange hop off the glass and then fired right back down again. This is where Paul Maurice talked about in Carolina, his crowd so enthusiastic that when they're not going well, the crowd knows when to pick things up, and he expected that to be the case here in Winnipeg as the first easy shot of the period is flagged down by Brian Boucher.
There are some buildings that the home crowd can get on you in a hurry, and it makes it a tough place to play if things aren't going well. But oftentimes you pick up just a little bit of energy. Somebody makes a hit, the crowd picks it up a little bit, and then you feel a little bit quicker and you gain a little bit of momentum. I mean, look at how the momentum's changed in this period for no appreciable reason. Winnipeg dominated the first period. They haven't had the puck at all here, as Carolina's been much better in the first 8.5 minutes of this period.
Wonderful. Noel is trying to send a message here. He's got his fourth line checkers out on the power play, and Meets with a shot, but Troy Bodie, Cormier, and Maxwell, you wouldn't expect would normally get power play time unless he's just going to roll everybody through in a preseason game. There's a bad angle shot off the side of the net. That's Cormier. Maxwell, who had that gaping net in the first period. Meets across for Bogosian, and back. Rolling puck shot, and Bodie couldn't reach it for the redirect.
That was a good look by Meech, the slap pass through the slot.
Bogosian sends it wide of the net. Meech steps up again. It got past Bodie, but Patrice Cormier's got it. The New Jersey draft choice sends it back around. Meech watched by Talusti. Now Maxwell unable to control, and finally Carolina gets it down, and just a few seconds remaining in this Winnipeg power play. Here's Heinze quickly in, sent it across, and it was broken up by Brian Allen as Evander Kane was headed to the net. Penalized players back, Kane from behind the net. Harrison gets into defensive position. That went off a skate, and Boucher pounces on it in the blue paint.
Couple of good chances for the Jets on the power play. Derek Meech, who's put up some good offensive numbers in the American League, trying to make the Jets squad, and one of the reasons is his versatility. There he makes a nice look to Troy Bodie, that slap pass through the slot, and then Ron Heinze, a beautiful feed to Evander Kane, but that's a nice play by Brian Allen, who turns and gets his stick into good position to deflect the pass away.
Well, Noel mentioned today that A lot of these guys have assets going for jobs. Here's Strikely in front, and he can't pull the trigger. Little weak shot. Kane on the doorstep, and Boucher down as Scheifele gets a scoring opportunity.
One thing I noticed here at the tail end of this play as to the strength of Mark Scheifele as just a young kid is Jay Harrison goes to shove him out of the way as he's sticking his or putting his stick into the goalie's glove for the rebound. Watch Scheifele. He doesn't get pushed over here as Harrison shoves him, and he doesn't go anywhere. It's a sign that there is some lower body strength for Mark Scheifele.
6'2", 184, as an 18-year-old. That puck out of play at the Carolina bench. We've just passed the 10-minute mark of the second period. Tim Brent, the goal scorer for Carolina. Back in Winnipeg, where moments ago, Ray spoke with Jeff Skinner.
Jeff, you're in the middle of the ice after most of your season on the wing. Last year, a natural center. Is there one position you're more comfortable with?
I don't know. I think I played center and junior, and then played the wing all of last year, like you said. So I think maybe I prefer center a little bit, but at the same time, I've played the wing for a year now, so I'm equally as comfortable, I think, playing both.
All the best, Jeff. Thanks. Have a great second year.
Sounded to me like he's saying, whatever the coach wants, I'll do.
It does, and it speaks to the versatility that a guy can go from position to position. And if you would have told me last year that he'd never played a game of center, it wouldn't have surprised me at all. He looks so comfortable on the wing.
Of course, he might just be torn because center's his natural position, but that wing spot might be with Eric Staal, and that's not a bad option. Ron Hainsey back in his own zone. And Hainsey will lead the Jets through center. That pass deflected in on Boucher, and he'll dish it off to Justin Bolt. Glenn Wesley, one of the ex-Hurricanes now involved in player development, was saying that Folk was so noticeable as a college player, as a great power play guy, but he's been really solid defensively. And as I say that, there was a giveaway in the zone, but they've been impressed with his complete game in this training camp.
They got a few of those ex-Hurricanes on the bench here. Tom Barrasso and Rod Brindamore are behind the bench as well for the Hurricanes tonight.
Ron Francis is upstairs with Glenn Wesley. Just have that reunion moving around from venue to venue.
They must have one heck of an alumni team.
Here's Jason Gregoire. He dishes, Scheifele squeezed off the puck, but a hit by Zach Boychuk. Boychuk out there now to complete a change with Bowman and Brandon Sutter. That puck off the official, and Scheifele onto it quickly. Jet fans trying to energize their team. Bogosian shot, and that was deflected off the stick of Wheeler. Here's Wheeler behind the net. Scheifele in support. Harrison works over Wheeler. But Wheeler comes out in front. Land a shot, rebound. Oh, Scheifele fanned on it. What a chance for Mark Scheifele. And now he'll hit off on the end of a shift that came close to producing the tying goal. Wheeler trying to cut in, unable to get the shot off. I think Scheifele was just out of gas as he was late on the change. Here comes Sutter. Paddle stopped by Mason all the way out to center, and Wheeler had it, unable to slide it through for Brian Little. Allen moves it around. Booty off the bench with a good check. Besterling shot knocked down en route. And sent out to center by Samson. Samson on that far side, unable to come up with it. Now gets it back. And it's knocked away by Troy Bodhi.
This is what an energy line is supposed to do. Bodie's had three good plays on this shift.
Bodie's had a good camp. Kid who grew up cheering for the Jets, said was brokenhearted when they left back in 96. And now with a tryout, trying to crack the lineup he grew up cheering for. He's had a goal in the preseason. He's had some scraps. He's been a plus three, so he's getting noticed. Will he stick? Troy Bodhi was with Carolina at the end of last year. Long pass down ice, and And there's the goal scorer, Tim Brent. And Brent nearly lost it to Antropov off his stick and back inside the Carolina line. And Antropov nearly came up with it again. Vernitra rolling it down into his own zone, and Kalusti gets chase. Meech gets back, takes a hit, gets it to Randy Jones. Meech ahead, and that's gloved down by Talusti, and he'll play it back into Winnipeg ice. 5 minutes, 55 seconds remaining here in the second period. And just that first minute goal in the second to report by Tim Brent. Meech, he'll dump it in. I was just finished the story on Meech. One of his advantages is that in his time in Detroit, played some forward as well. So Claude Dewell has considered that option. Meech is a guy that can play up or back as a multi-purpose player for Winnipeg.
Coaches love to have options with their lineup. It creates internal tension and internal pressure on your lineup. Meech might give them a little bit of versatility.
Here's Caberlet giving it up. Puck behind the net to the side. Kane fishing for it. But it's underneath Brian Boucher in the Carolina goal mouth.
We've been talking a lot about Mark Scheifele. From the first shift of the game, he's been noticeable. He steals a puck, gets in tight, shows some defensive awareness after the puck's turned over in the middle of the ice. He comes straight back to the net, and then he's had a couple of chances here in the second period. He fans on that one, and he whiffs on this rebound attempt in front of Brian Boucher. But it's been a good 35 minutes for Mark Scheifele as he continues to try and impress Coach Claude Noel and GM Kevin Cheveldayoff.
He said his goal is to prove that he was the right pick for this team, and I think the Jets already feel that way. Claude Noel mentioning today that the happiest guys are the scouts who recommended that the number 7 pick should be Mark Scheifele. Here's Keane over the line, Scheifele with him. Lost it, nearly got it back again, and now Gregoire a shot. Scheifele up with the rebound, tracked by Falk, a point shot, and that deflects wide off the stick of Festerling, who's played over 80 games in the NHL, still looking for his first National Hockey League goal. Now Talusti fanned on a pass, and it slides through center. Carolina makes a change as Festerling goes back in his own zone.
Sometimes the road to the NHL, it takes a lot of turns. Brett Festerling's played over 80 games in the NHL, but he's played for 7 American Hockey League teams as well.
And now Keane is dumped, and there will be a penalty. Derek Joslin, the former San Jose Shark, upending Keane, and Winnipeg gets another power play chance.
Keane likes to take the puck on the right side and drive it to the net. This time he takes the puck down the left wing, and when he gets outside of Joslin, Joslin wants to poke the puck. He pushes his feet, Keane goes down, and Kane's outside speed has forced Joslin into a penalty, and the Jets get another power play as they look for the equalizer.
Paul Maurice's penalty kill has been perfect so far in the postseason, in the preseason, and 3 for 3 tonight. He says, I'm not getting too excited about it. It was good in the preseason last year, and we struggled throughout the regular season. Jets look for the equalizer with Little, Glad, Wheeler, along with Derek Beach and Zach Bogosian. And there is Talusti knocking it off the stick of Little and down into Winnipeg ice. Meech leads the attack. Flip doesn't get deep. Brian Allen gloves it down but can't clear. And now gets it back, and this time he'll make sure.
Brian Allen's had a very good first 2 periods for Carolina. He was acquired last year from Florida. They had to guard a little bit with some knee problems, how much he could practice, but he adds a big physical presence to an otherwise not very physical Carolina defense.
Wheeler was loose, unable to take the pass, and now a one-handed effort that's broken up by McBain. And the Jets didn't have anything going in the first minute of this power play. Let's see if they can change it here. A good stretch pass for Gregoire. Jason Gregoire tracked by McBain. Trying to get it through for Scheifele, who takes it away from Falk. Centers, and Kane missed the pass. when he was left alone in front. Brandon Sutter back the other way.
The pass from Scheifele was a good one. However, it went into kind of the no-fly zone for Kane, right between his stick and feet.
Now Gregoire over the line, dropped for Scheifele. Stays with it, passes it across. Kane's the shot, rebound, and Kane couldn't find it. Neither can Scheifele, and the Canes get it outside the line. A couple dozen seconds remaining in this fourth power play of the night for Winnipeg. And the Canes send it 200 feet. Ron Hainsey ahead. They had Antropov poaching at the line. Here's Antropov now after it. Along the boards, gets it back. Mark Stewart returns it. Antropov. Side of the net. Bermese drop. Antropov. Penalized players back. And look out. They almost got caught. Winnipeg turning it the other way. Pasanen over the line. That pass broken up. Pasanen, who played in the KHL last year, and a few years back had seven games with the Pittsburgh Penguins. Skinner in his own zone gives it up, but then gets bailed out by Jussi Jokinen. Now Festerling to the attack. Bad angle shot, and Brian Boucher stops that. Well, there's quite a connection between the Winnipeg Jets and the Barrie Colts. Alexander Bermestov, Brian Little, and Mark Scheifele, the top three centers tonight for Winnipeg, all former Colts. And of course, Scheifele, coached last year by arguably the greatest Jet of them all, Dale Hawerchuk. And so I guess it makes some sense, because the old team in Barrie was the Barrie Flyers, and there would be a connection to the Winnipeg Jets, no, Ray?
Makes you wonder if that's where their whole scouting department lives. You get three first-rounders in 5 years out of the Barrie Colts. And you think Dale Hawerchuk's watching young Scheifele with a foot on each side of the fence. If he doesn't stick, he goes back to Barrie, and they become instantly a very good team.
There's a jam play by Maxwell and a paddle-down stop by Boucher. And you know Hawerchuk's cheering for him. Mark mentioned this morning that he gets texts from his junior coach encouraging him, but he would be a difference maker at the Ontario Hockey League level, to be sure.
And you know, Hawerchuk, like many of those 18-year-old players that made it and stayed, they have a different perspective. We can all speculate as
there's
that
Dale.
Is... No, I don't think it is. We can all speculate what it's like to come and play as an 18-year-old in the National Hockey League, but Hawerchuk was able to thrive as an 18-year-old and would be able to help Scheifele with some of the things that he may encounter along the way.
Well, if Mark wonders how Dale did in his first year, he only has to look at his jersey number. 45 goals in his rookie year. Back at the point. That shot wired high. Into the final minute of the second period. Hurricanes with the lead, and Jet fans want something to cheer about. Here's Troy Boldy trying to accommodate them. Boldy along the wall. Watched closely by Jocelyn. Beats it back at the point. It'll be kept in by Cormier. Maxwell rolls it towards Boucher, and a little chop there from Boldy. Boucher hangs on.
Boldy's had a good couple of shifts here towards the latter half of the second period, providing some energy for the Jets. A big man who's played 100 games in the National Hockey League, and he's in a little bit of a struggle here for his spot in Winnipeg. They have Chris Thorburn, who has been in Atlanta the last couple of years, to play that bigger forward energy role. So Bodie's got to make an impression, and there's just this and one more game left to do so.
Under a half minute left in this second period. The Hurricanes' lone goal of the game came in the opening minute of period number two. Ron Hainsey, one last rush here, and like Wheeler might have been offside. Play allowed to continue. Hainsey, shot a wide. Wheeler and Boucher down to cover. Short side with 3.3 seconds to go.
Well, the Jets have had a lot of close calls around the front of the net. Hainsey gets the puck right down Main Street. As the Jets are going to work the puck into the zone.
Close call at the line.
But okay, I think that play is onside. and Hainsey's shot misses the net. If that puck bounces another foot, Wheeler's going to have an open net to push it in.
So one last face-off. To the right of Brian Boucher as Little digs in, but the face-off is won by Tim Brent. Again, one of the reasons they got Tim Brent. Another might be a little supporting cast scoring, which he supplied early in the period. And after 40 minutes in Winnipeg, 1-0 Carolina. Here again, James Duffy. Returns. We're getting set for the third period here in Winnipeg tonight, where Carolina has the lead, and Jeff Skinner Ray has indicated there won't be any sophomore jinx, at least based on his first 40 minutes.
What a wonderful player to watch. He can do so many things in tight spaces. When I watch Skinner play, I'm amazed constantly about how he's able to squeeze himself through the smallest of spaces. He's such a tremendous skater. He's got great balance. Watch how he gets up on his edges here. Doesn't lose his balance, keeps the play alive. And then this is the move of the night here as he goes through the tiniest of holes between Derek Meech and Randy Jones, puts it through his own feet. I asked him at a commercial break, I said, do you practice that move much? He said, no, that was lucky. You don't make that move in an NHL game on luck. Kid's a heck of a player.
And there's been some concern in Carolina about faceoff ability. He lost that drop, but had been at 50%. Coming into the third period. So not bad in the faceoffs either. Young Mark Scheifele, 2-6 in the faceoff circle, but he's got company tonight as Winnipeg has won only 37% of the draws. Here's Zach Dolphy battling. Skinner side of the net. Look at that swivel in front of the net. And a close call there as Chris Mason handled it. But boy, another example of how good he is on his skates, just that little pivot at the side of the net.
Mark Stewart should bring stability to the Winnipeg blue line. Came over in a trade from Boston last year. He stands up as Jokinen's not expecting him to and runs him over. And then here's Skinner, knocked down once. When the puck comes to him, look how quickly he gets to the front of the net. There's not much room to make that move, yet he's able to get it to the front and force it into the pads of Chris Mason.
Here's Randy Jones up the boards. That was cut off. Now behind the net, Dwyer. It's another line that Paul Maurice said we might see during the season for Carolina. Tim Brent, along with Dwyer and Talusti, as a third or fourth line unit for the Hurricanes. And they produced the only goal so far tonight. Maxwell knocked Talusti off the puck. But you can feel the building ready to explode, waiting for something to cheer for here. And so far, the Jets have been held at bay. There's a hit by Cormier as Dwyer moves it ahead, got to the red line, dropped it in. And Carolina gets on it. Cormier looks rink wide. And now Troy Bodie skating it after it. Changes direction, sends it across, and nobody there for Winnipeg. And back the other way, Drayson Bowman flicks it in. Zach Boychuk's on it. He's hit by Hainsey. There's Bowman getting bumped by Kane. After it is Sutter. Give and go, and Sutter's shot is fanned on, ends up well wide. And Bowman again trying to hook up with Sutter. For me, get power play time this year. Here's a break. Scheifele trying to barge through, and it's knocked off his stick as Derek Joslin cut him off the pass. In front, Kane, rebound. Oh, what a toe stop! A brilliant save by Boucher. Back to back stops on Evander Kane, set up by Mark Scheifele. Wow. They were chanting Brian Boucher, trying to get in his kitchen a bit, and he responds with a save of the night. Here's Gregoire trying to center it. And it's chipped ahead by Samson. Quick Sutter flicks it in for Carolina. That's given the building some energy, though. The close call of Andrew Kane. Stopped twice. Great scoring chances by Brian Boucher. And now a penalty against Winnipeg upcoming. It will be a holding call.
Scheifele has a chance through the middle of the ice, and he's not going to get through as Joslin makes a nice play and closes it off. But Scheifele stays with it. Not only does he stay with it, he's got the wherewithal to get the puck to Evander Kane in the slot. Kane is in the garden spot, 15 feet out in front. Boucher with two excellent saves on Evander Kane, but another glimpse of Mark Scheifele's ability. And then the other youngster, the 2010 first-rounder, Alexander Burmistrov, goes to the penalty box for holding. Carolina will go back on the power play.
Here's Skinner, his shot, and that deflects high. McBain from Dutton. He's out with Kaberle. Jokinen, Skinner, and Dolby, and that puck flipped into the Winnipeg bench. 28-14, the shots Winnipeg, and yet Carolina has the lead.
Here's the hold on Burmistrov as he gets his left hand off his stick and grabs onto Samson.
Third power play of the night for Carolina. Face-off won by Skinner against Antropov. Thomas Kaberle. Now Jokinen. He looks rink wide. Here's the shot, and McBain fired it right on. McBain's got it again. No relation to the McBain that played as a Winnipeg Jet. Back in the day, Andrew McBain.
Had a couple of good seasons. I played with him on a world championship team one year.
Jokinen in, and again, boy, the edges for Skinner or something, aren't they?
Incredible how he can make the turn, yet get his stick into position to complete the play as well.
Boy, he's been a treat to watch. Like another big year is upcoming for the Calder Trophy winner. Now Falk steps up. Brandon Sutter along the boards, and the Hurricanes have said they're going to use him in power play opportunities this year. Didn't get power play time last year. That shot stopped by Mason. Rebound is tipped. Here's a backhand, and it's blocked as Bowman couldn't get it through. Blocked by Mark Stewart. Falk at the point. Brandon Sutter got a man and a great pickoff, and here's a two-on-one. Andrew Ladd to the attack, jumping up Bogosian, and Ladd fired it over the crossbar just high on that shorthanded chance. So that's a couple of shorthanded opportunities for the Jets tonight.
When Ladd was going up on the two-on-one with Little, Sutter got on his horse and he was able to take Little away from the play as Sutter was backchecking. He pointed to the defenseman to take Andrew Ladd. It turned out to be basically Ladd's shot on a one-on-one because of Sutter's good work.
Paul Maurice said this morning, we have never had to say anything about defense to Brandon Sutter. The kid got it from day one. Harrison got back in a hurry. Now Tim Brent up ahead it goes. Patrick Dwyer tries to chip and chase, working against Festerling. That Festerling wouldn't let him by. Off the boards, but kept in by Harrison. Festerling trying to make a move and had his pocket picked, trying to buy a little extra time for a change, and nearly gave up a odd man rush.
As we can continue the Jeff Skinner skating clinic, watch how quickly he makes this move, pivot to the forehand, forces Chris Mason to make the save, and then here's the play by Brandon Sutter. It's a two-on-one, and you're going to see Sutter at the top of your screen telling Justin Falk to go over to Ladd because he can take care of Brian Little. That's work by Sutter to get into position and hockey IQ to be in the right place and point and coach Justin Falk on the play.
Approaching the 6 minute mark of the third period. Here's Ron Hainsey wheeling to center. That's broken up, but countering is Nash. He centers it across, and Samson on the near side is checked, gets it back again, and now loses it, and Bodie tries to send away Wheeler. That took the icing, unless Wheeler got there, and he did not. Fans thought he did, but icing's the call as the pass came from the Winnipeg side of the red line.
I haven't seen Blake Wheeler live a whole lot, but wow, can he cover the ice? The big man covers a lot of ice with each stride. 99% of the time, when there's a controversial icing call, the linesmen get it right, and they get this one right here as it's Joslin's stick that gets there before Wheeler.
So we wondered about an offside in the second period. Well, I did. You didn't.
No, they got that one right, too.
Guys are batting 100% again. Brian Pancik and Don Henderson working the lines and in midseason form. The puck gets by Cabrelet. And racing back is Dolphy. Carolina likes his speed, too. Zach Dolphy. He can fly. It's almost a prerequisite to play the league now, isn't it?
It is. However, you've got to be able to think while you're skating fast. There's a lot of guys that can go fast. They're not sure where they're going. They just get to where they're going in a high speed, but they have no hockey IQ to help with it. You've got to be able to think while you're going quickly.
Kane will spin it back. Gregoire's got it. He feeds it back to Kane. Here's the shot. Oh, and that one rips the pass right off Brian Boucher. Take that. Evander Kane says after the great stops earlier by Boucher. You know,
Brian Boucher has been excellent in goal for Carolina. He's been tested several times by Evander Kane tonight. Kane's had three really good opportunities that Boucher has been on target with. The last one is a wrister that knocks the mask off of Brian Boucher. Here's Evander Kane to my left. 14 goals as a rookie, 19 last year. He will be a 25 goal scorer as he charges the net and has a terrific release on his wrist shot. He's an edgy player too. He doesn't have a whole lot of fans on the opponents that he plays against.
Puck gets flipped up in the bench. Another product of Vancouver, and there seems to be a lot of those young stars coming out of your area, right?
Yeah, Vander played at the North Shore Winter Club, which is the place prior to him that Ben Maxwell starred at as well. They run some pretty good players out of there, and there's a good one you might have heard of from the Burnaby Winter Club that's in Edmonton these days. Ryan Nugent-Hopkins with 3 points last night for the Oilers.
Yes, he did. They got the folks in Edmonton excited on a line with Hall and Everly. There's a big hit by Festerling. And Hainsey took a run, and they're going to get a penalty.
Festerling's going to get a call here for interference. So the call would be that he makes contact before the Carolina player can play the puck. Dwyer's okay, and you can see that he doesn't have the puck. Man, that's a tight one for Festerling. He's already committed to the hit here. You can see the puck is on the sideboards when he runs over top of Dwyer.
Claude Noel has to send the penalty killing unit out again. Wheeler,
Little,
Bogosian, and Stewart. Got to keep it a one goal game. There's the pass for McBean, and that one rang off the post. Close side on Mason.
Well, Jeff Skinner's starting to put a clinic on here. That was a great pass.
Now McBean reaches out, got it, shot it wide, and it will boomerang all the way back into the Carolina zone. Thomas Cabrelet back to get it. Eight times, 40 points or more in his NHL career. At the line, it'll be dumped in by Dolphy. Chance to clear for Jones, and it's knocked down by McBean. And then McBean got the stick up on Ladd. And that'll be a penalty, and let's find out the severity of the infraction.
No blood, it looks like, for Ladd. He's trying. Well, maybe a little bit on his lip. If he keeps working at it, he's going to have enough there.
Now that high stick might have saved a break. It looked like Ladd might be breaking away.
And it is a four-minute minor. Here's the play earlier from Jeff Skinner. He takes the Cabrelet feed and goes right through the seam to McBain. McBain hits the goalpost underneath the glove of Chris Mason. But that's a terrific feed by Jeff Skinner. Both posts, left post, right post, somehow stays out. And the Jets will have a 2 minute and 48 second power play once this 4-on-4 hockey is finished here. A minute 12 of 4-on-4, and then the Jets go on the power play.
Ladd Little are on the ice against Talusti. And Sutter, that shot just whistled wide. Bounces out in front. Brian Little's got it. He'll beat it back to Hainsey. Ron Hainsey fires, and that's blocked. And Brian Allen, slow to get up. Here's Brandon Sutter with Talusti catching up in front. And Jones got all the way back to break that play up. Great play by Randy Jones, and now back the other way goes Little. 4-on-4 wide open as Little swings wide. Bogosian off the bench, and that one takes a bite out of Brandon Sutter. Now he's on the lift. Two Hurricanes shake it up 4-on-4 with shot blocks. And Sutter in difficulty as he gets to the bench. Here comes Skinner, and Bogosian wouldn't let him by. Now Meech ahead. 20 seconds remaining in the 4-on-4. Burmistra over the line, sent it through. Wheeler couldn't tip it. Wheeler and Burmistra with Meech and Bogosian. Puck played to an open wing. Bogosian in after it, and it's chipped by him, by Harrison. Here's Skinner. And Skinner slowed up by Burmistra, who got back in a hurry in defensive support. And Skinner at the end of a shift heads off. Now Winnipeg to the power play. Burmistra can't get it through against Harrison. Harrison a weak backhand, but it does get past Hainsey, and Mason has to come out of the net and get it out to center. Under 2.5 minutes remaining in the power play. We've hit 10 minutes of the third. Still 1-0 Carolina. Evander Kane, a bouncing puck, and he can't barge through. Ryan Allen lost it along the boards. Hainsey a shot, and that grazed Kane, but still went wide. Allen a chance to clear, and he does. 30 shots for the Jets, but they haven't beaten Brian Boucher.
You know, sometimes the goaltenders think they help with that quick up. It seems like 90% of the time they pass it to the forwards that are skating back towards them. Mason missed the pass, it went down the ice. Carolina ices it back.
Now Cormier to the attack, puts it in front, Kane scores! Most chances in the third, finally solved Brian Boucher.
Bogosian makes a terrific pass to Hainsey, and if you'll remember back in the second period, rather the pass is up on the wing. It's not Hainsey, it's Cormier with the puck, and Cormier feeds it across to Kane, and Kane, who's had three or four real good scoring chances, takes the Cormier feed and chips it high. Brian Boucher, a Jet power play goal with just over 9 minutes left, has equaled the score at 1. But Bogosian starts this with a terrific long feed to Patrice Cormier. Head up, he's looking for the outlet, and it's crisp and it's on the tape, and Cormier makes a nice pass. Joslin can't get to the front side of Kane, and Kane tips it in from just outside the goal crease.
Second of the preseason for Evander Kane. Cormier and Bogosian draw assists, and here's Cormier back again. And that shot inches wide, far side. Well, the building was waiting to erupt, and it does, as Evander Kane has tied it in the third.
High draft pick by the Atlanta Thrashers has really lost his way a little bit defensively. He's minus 45 in the last 2 years. Well, there's Charlie Huddy, and one of Charlie Huddy's charges this year will be to help Zach Bogosian reach his potential, more so in the defensive zone. But he's got offensive game too. This is a great feed that we saw to Cormier. Cormier finds Kane and ties the game up, but Bogosian is a player that's got the label of potential, but he's become a bit of a turnover machine. Huddy will try and return him to simplicity. Simple, quick, clean passes out of the zone to become more reliable in his own zone.
I mentioned this morning how much he likes Bogosian's speed.
And I talked to Shane Knight, CC, before the game, who's doing the radio color after retiring as a member of the Boston Bruins. And he mentioned that Mark Stewart most likely will be the partner for Bogosian, an old teammate of his. And he said Stewart plays the type of game that will help.
Wheeler scores! Blake Wheeler! 2-1 Winnipeg! His first shot of the night. We talked about him not shooting. Look what happens when he does.
But Wheeler starts the play on the turnover, and once Little drives it wide, Wheeler finds some open space, and he goes through the screen of Caberle in front of the net. Caberle is standing beside Andrew Ladd. Ladd and gets into the sight line of Boucher, and Wheeler, who has been noticeable for his size and speed, gives Winnipeg the lead.
So now the score reflecting the shot advantage that Winnipeg had built through the night. 32-17, and now with under 8 minutes to go, the Jets have their first lead of the night. Here's Derek Meech looking for more, and that shot got through off Boucher. Behind the net, Tim Brent. Carolina suddenly on its heels. That pass got past Dwyer the length of the ice, and Jones will go back for the icing touch-up. And folks in Winnipeg like what they see here in the third period, as Blake Wheeler has scored at 11:49. The goals come 64 seconds apart.
We talked off the top about Andrew Ladd, the captain, and how he leads by example. It's not always the most pretty of games, but look, he trips up, he falls down, he gets himself back into the play, and by going all the way to the net with never touching the puck, he becomes the screen that makes Boucher work to find it. He can't get a handle on Wheeler's shot. Excellent effort by Andrew Ladd and Wheeler. They convert the little pass.
Basinen chips it to Antropov, back to Festerling. His shot is blocked as that one off to Lusty, and he'll limp on. A few bruises on that Carolina bench because of shot blocks here in the third period. Sutter, Talusti, and Allen. There's Sutter bouncing it down, and that's swiped away by Chris Mason. Is not cleared. Joslin fires, and that one hit traffic on route. Vermeestroff in his own zone. He'll carry it out. With a move at center, and rolls it one-handed deep into Carolina ice. 6.5 minutes on the clock in the third. Antropov in on the forecheck, but it's big Derek Joslin. He gets knocked down by Kane. And then Kane gets bodied in turn by Brandon Sutter. Back inside the line, and here comes Brent Sutter. His shot weak and wide. Samsonov's after it. Pitching in is Caberle. He can't center. Kane stood up by Riley Nash, and Samsonov will chop it deep. Jay Harrison moves up. Samsonov can't reach it, but away goes Kane with Scheifele. And Gregoire in front, and then cut by Scheifele to the line. Sent back in by Bogosian. Riley Nash, Kane in front of his own bench. And Winnipeg back up with it, and play stopped. We've got a penalty, and it looks like it's going against Carolina.
All right, grab those Cromar printing.
The Winnipeg Jets have a new home on Canada's sports leader. Catch over 60 regional Jet games on our special TSN Jets channel. For more information and channel listings, visit tsn.ca/jets. Who will be shorthanded, Ray? They were called for too many men on the ice in that scramble in front of the Winnipeg bench.
Well, you clearly see six guys on the ice for the Jets. So they gave up a goal at the start of the second period on a bad change. Now they're shorthanded because they made another bad change. Small detail that kind of belies the time of year you're at.
Knocked down, and that shot is blocked by Heinze. Dolpe couldn't get it through. Zach Dolpe's got it from the boards. Works it to Folk. His shot is blocked, and that went off Little, and now will be cleared by Andrew Ladd. Do you think we'll see Ladd and Little killing penalties as frequently as we've seen tonight?
Well, when you're 27th in the league as they were last year, you're going to go with your better players. There's so much still up in the air for Claude Noel. He was telling us this morning that, you know, he hasn't seen his full team yet. He's only been with the team for a couple of games. But both players do kill penalties, and both of them, I would suspect, would be regular participants in it.
And for Mistrop, you wonder how much penalty killing time he got last year. Now with Nick Antropov. And 58 seconds left in the Winnipeg penalty being served by Patrice Cormier. Well, a little concerned by the fact that after Friday's final preseason game, there'll be over a week break before the regular season begins. He feels that Montreal will have an advantage coming in for the first regular season game, although can you imagine the atmosphere here for opening night for the Montreal Canadiens? I'd like to think that might balance out. Don't you think, Ray? Here's a shot, Mason the save.
Yeah, Russ can be equalized by what will be an absolute madhouse here.
Joslin shot, that doesn't get through. Under 4 minutes left in the third period, and that gets by Joslin. Joslin, they'll have to go back to get it. And now down to 20 seconds remaining on this Hurricane power play as they look for the equalizer. Loose puck, and that's swatted back into the team zone by Brian Little. Boucher gives it away. Little pouncing on it. Little centers. It'll come back to Stewart. Can't get the shot through. But the Jets have returned to full strength with 3:20 left. Goals just over a minute apart here in the third. Andrew Ladd is met by Caberlet and lost control of the puck. Here's Wheeler, who has the potential game winner. Caberlet to the red line. Dwyer gets it deep. After it goes Tim Brent, who has the goal for Carolina. He takes down Heinze. Young Zach Bogosian. Third pick in the 2008 draft. Wheeler gets it into Carolina ice. Justin Folk. Jokinen went rink wide, nobody there, and he took a hit from Cormier. Randy Jones for Pasanen. Johnny Pasanen. He'll flip it deep to Troy Bodie's after. Bodie going to the net, and Boucher will pounce on that. Well, those will bring back some memories, Ray.
Oh, you bet. When I think of the Jets jerseys like that, I think of Timu Solani and Dale Hawerchuk going into the old building that had boards that were as hard as stone when you went in there. This is a much nicer upgrade here. I'll tell you, you know, there's a little bit made about it's a smaller building. Man, the people are close. There's a great atmosphere. It's loud in here.
Got that low roof like the Shark Tank.
I thought about it in the anthem, CC, the way the sound bounced around as well. This is going to be a real nice boost for these players playing at home 41 times here.
Vermeestroff knocked down. Chris Mason was saying the difference was noticeable for the first day getting on the ice 3 weeks before training camp opened. He said, I'm on the front page of the sports news just for a workout.
And there may be some times when things don't go so well, you'll hope for a little more anonymity.
Won't be any of that here.
No, certainly not.
Down to the final 90 seconds of regulation time. And Carolina answer with an equalizer. Out of the net comes Boucher for the extra attacker. Off the boards and out. And Harrison's got to scramble back. Shifley went after it. So Mark Shifley on the ice with just over a minute to go, protecting a one-goal lead.
Well, you might as well see what else he can do as Brian Boucher will work his way back to the Carolina net with the faceoff just outside the blue line. The Hurricanes are going to take their time out. Boucher's had a very good night for Carolina. He has been start to finish probably their best player. Jeff Skinner's had a very good night. And for the Jets, it seems for 40 minutes they've been the better team, quicker, stronger on the puck. And it's led to two third period goals in just over a minute. The first was a power play goal. Cormier makes a nice feed to Evander Kane, who's had a very noticeable third period. And then Brian Little to Blake Wheeler. Wheeler finally shoots the puck. He beats Boucher to the glove side with Andrew Ladd providing the screen. That is the margin of difference at this time.
Shots 24-8 since the first period. Brian Boucher, we joked about this morning about getting out of that goaltending graveyard in Philadelphia, but he did remind everybody that he loved Philadelphia enough to go back there a second time, but he'll be a good caddy for Cam Ward, a nice backup for one of the best goaltenders in the National Hockey League.
And maybe that's a goaltender that can earn you those 2 points that were the difference making the playoffs or not.
Boucher back to the bench, the extra attacker on Gaberle in his own zone, and now down to a final minute of regulation time. Puck at center, and here's Dolpe. Looked like he almost had a lane to the net there. Sutter tries to center, broke it up, and turning with it is Kane. Chips it ahead, just short of the icing line, and Gaberle back to play it. Out at center, Skinner tapped it past Haynes. He couldn't get it beyond Bogosian. Here's Kane, empty net! And they're on their feet at the MTS.
I was waiting for the horn to finish. I think that guy's pretty excited that runs the horn. Turnover at the line that's caused by Zach Bogosian. Kane gets the puck on the sidewall and is able to shoot it into the empty net. And the Jets will run home with a 3-1 lead.
Carolina will be back here October the 22nd. And again, these are divisional rivals this year. Here's Pasanen with a shot high. Last year, Carolina won 5 of the 6. 5-0-1 against Atlanta. Jets will be determined to improve that. And they have a preseason victory here tonight as they score 3 in the 3rd to win it 3-1.
It will not be boring here in Winnipeg this year. That's an exciting team to watch.
Well, they score goals 64 seconds apart midway through the third. Kane and Wheeler, Kane into an empty net. Solid effort for Chris Mason. And Winnipeg wins it 3-1. Fun to be back in Winnipeg. So long, everybody. SportsCenter is now.